Now I am about to graduate from the Indian Institute of Space Science and Technology, Trivandrum. This institute started some 10 years ago, 11 to be exact. It was started to
scan
provide manpower to the Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, as you must all be know. The thing about IIST, that is the Indian Institute of Space Science and Technology, is that it is Asia's first ever space science institute that is meant ideally for, entirely for space science studies. So what happens, I'll quickly just skim through what my studies have been about, and then I'll go back to how my journey has been. So right now, where I am, I will be graduating in next 1 month.
Yes, you may.
And so the policy of our institute is that we have this bond that we sign. After completing the bachelor's program. So there are three branches: aerospace, avionics, and engineering physics.
Rajat kar diya submit.
Total of 140 students are selected every year based on their this JE advanced rank. And so I am in the avionics. That is basically electronics and communication in a fancier and aviation one.
Ma'am, I have submitted.
But it's more or less the same thing. So I'll be joining ISRO in the next 3 months. Once, because of the whole corona situation, it might get delayed, but that's the plan. So we join at the position of scientist C, and that's what the current plan is. Going back,
Divyam, upload kar dijiye aapke. Kunisha, upload kar do.
I would say that it started. I mean, the whole fascination of science did not just come out of nowhere. It was basically because, one, my dad is an electrical engineer, so ever since my childhood, I've seen him repair every piece of equipment in our house, every electronic. So he's made sure I see what the insides are like. So that has always struck my mind in a different sense, and I've always been curious about it as to how things work and why do they work at all or everything. So, but I must say, I was never a sincere kid at school. Never. I was one of those who would be at every place playing basketball or just doing debates and everything else. So that was actually the plan ever since when I was growing up. I was like, what am I going to do in future in life? So starting from fifth standard, from cricketer to singer to even a dancer. I'm a horrible dancer. Even a dancer. And then at some point, a scientist. Of course, why not scientist? And then it changed to mathematician. So in ninth standard, it settled on mathematician. One of the major push for this, I would say, goes to actually Mission for Excellence when it started, because when I was in 9th standard, I joined this place and there was this teacher, Nitin Singh sir. He used to teach us mathematics of which were definitely not of our level. It was not meant for 9th standard student. It was some MIT ka game theory ka papers, some group theory ka papers, and you know, we learned calculus and integration wala thing in 9th and 10th itself, because that's how he taught us. So it was very obvious. It was not like a big deal at that point. So the way he simplified mathematics for us was actually a big push. And as you all know, teachers are really someone who leave a huge impression on us. Even these small instances can actually change how your mind models and it grows. So that was the first step, and I had a friend circle who was ridiculously into all the mathematics stuff, and you know, we used to sit and do these books, solve them randomly. I mean, you can call us geeky, but I would not like to say that. So we used to do that a lot, and it was pretty promoted and, you know, supported from this place where we were at that point. And fortunately, I think it was especially for our batch, because all people in our batch, it was a very small batch at that point. All of us were interested in anything but what was going on in the process wala thing in school. We wanted to learn everything chalega, but not this mainstream stuff. We didn't want to learn that. We wanted to learn what actually stirred our curiosity. And fortunately, Nitin Singh sir made sure of that. So even he used to teach us chemistry out of randomly, physics also, but he always taught us what we wanted to learn, and you know, he never brought it to this judging us to a level that we are still kids. He just taught us like it should be taught. So anyway, that was 9th standard, and I continued here in 10th, 11th and 12th. Till then, I had absolutely no plan for JEE. Like, honestly, for me, I felt the idea of JE Advanced was ridiculous. Because one of the primary reasons, because everyone around me, I saw they were all studying 24/7, and I could not give that much time to just sitting in front of, you know, books and study, because I felt like this is just too much effort to put in to just get one thing. So the initial plan for me was to go to DU and pursue mathematics honors, because all of us had, I mean, I especially had this whole idea in my head that, you know, these great figures were like G.H. Hardy and all these fancy people, and like, okay, life mein kabhi Cambridge jayenge, abhi DU se start karte hain. So I joined Delhi University's this college, IP college for women. I somehow got it based on my, I don't know how, but kuch karke, but mera ye jo 12th score tha, uske basis pe the percentage I got into this. This is a not campus college, which I don't know how I got it, but anyway, till the last list I got it. So I went there and I saw the people who were there. It was nice, it was very nice. I mean, someone who wants to study, but you know, what I felt was lacking was the challenge that I was looking for. So, I mean, when we grow up, we have this ridiculous need for challenges, and that is what I was also, I felt that this is something that I'm not seeing right now. And some of my friends who were studying with me in the same coaching and in the school itself, we were the same set of groups. So somehow one of them went to IIC Bangalore, the other went to BITS Kalani, aise karke some people went somewhere. So, but I was in DU and I was like, okay, what else can be done? So that one day what happened was, I was packing all my books to give it away, because up to college mein aage, why do you need DC Pandey and H.C. Verma and all that thing. So I was packing all my books, and let me tell you, I was good at maths. Good as in like theek tha aa jati thi, basic jo bhi aata tha. But I was not so good at physics, because I could not put in the effort, you know, it needs, because someone can teach you something, but you have to learn on your own. No one can give you that. So I was not so good at physics, and I was packing all my books. So there was this DC Pandey, I'm sure all of you must be familiar with this DC Pandey ka subjective books used to come. So there was this one that my brother had bought, and I saw that the book was ekdam naya, the chamak raha tha ki like haath bhi nahi lagaya isko, and that is when I felt ridiculous. I'm like, so physics has this entire world of things and understanding how the nature works. That is exactly what physics is. I mean, theek hai, it has been brought down to kinematics and linear motion and this rotational motion, and you know, but what at that point physics was something magical, and I was like, oh my god, I don't even know this bit. That's not fair. That is when I decided to give it another try, take a drop for another 8 months, I think, something 8 months, because it was already October tab tak, and I was like, why not give it a try to JE? I mean, everyone's talking about it. And that is when I got to know, and I always had this dream for ISRO. But you know, when we are kids, we don't really know what's our limitation. So when I thought about ISRO, I always said, hey, that's still bahut mushkil. I mean, it's just too much in the future, and it's like something ridiculously difficult to achieve. But so I had left that. But when I was taking a drop, one of my family members told me that there is this institute through which you can go to ISRO, but you need to have a JE means advanced ka rank for that. I'm like, okay, then maybe it's worth it. Let's give it a try. So that is when I came to Nitin sir again. I was already there till 12th standard, and we studied for another 8 months. I had never put in so much effort, but I had to. So because that is what JE requires. I mean, you cannot leave the slack, as sad as it might be that you have to study so much. But I think it's in the end, if you've thought it through and this is what you want to do, it pays off. It really does. So after the end of it, I gave the JE Advanced. I had got some rank. My score was very funny and very evident. And I did not study mathematics itna zyada. I just did the test series which the coaching had given us. And you know, I just used to do that because maths was something I was thoda bahut confident with. But physics was something I had to pay a lot of attention to. So I made sure I paid a lot of attention to. But when you see my advanced ka score, it reflects the inclination towards mathematics. I guess that's just our nature. We cannot learn, I mean, we cannot let go of what we love. So I had like mathematics mein, advanced mein, I got 98 marks. In physics, I got 62 or 61, I don't remember. And in chemistry, I got 40. Okay, I was ridiculous at for chemistry, let me tell you. Although, I mean, I just felt that the chemistry we was taught in the best manner possible in our institute, in this coaching. I would say that the way Neelam ma'am taught was amazing. I had always loved that. But in case it's just about the personal thing. That's why it did not go so well for me. But anyway, overall, I got the score and I got into IIST. And IIST is an entirely research-based institute. It's not like your IITs where there is a lot other scope as well. Like it's more into the industrial side. IIST is very research-based. All our professors are doing active research with in collaboration with ISRO and without it as well. Incredible amount of research. So I mean, for the research, they get a lot of money. So. Yeah, that is my story about how and where I changed my plans and this happened. And I, as I understand, most of you are from 11th standard and just entered 11th standard. And I can understand this point, bahut zyada confusion hota hai and you really don't know what and how to prepare because you don't want to risk any of it. And see, I was at your place some 6 or 7 years ago. Oh my god, it's a long time. But yeah, I was at your place sometime. And people are bahut zyada dare hote hain that kya hoga, kitna hoga, pahunchenge nahi pahunchenge, ye race mein bhagna hai, bahut kuch karna hai. But you know, this is something okay, so one thing I would suggest you all to just think is like take some time and just think that okay, this is what you want, right? This is you want to go to an IIT or you want to pursue engineering. And let me tell you, IIT is not the end of it. It's of course the best place to study engineering in India. But don't be like, if some of you want to go into research, please consider IIST Bangalore. Please consider ISERS, which are incredible at the moment. If you want to pursue mathematics, all of this can be done with the same preparation that goes into this JEE ka preparation. But I'm just telling you, like, there are multiple options that you should know about, you know, IIT ke alawa bhi kya hai. It's IIT is not the end of the day. But kyunki it happens that you don't get a rank within 10,000 and then you're like, ab to kisi layak nahi bache. Aisa nahi hota. There are multiple places where you can apply. You just have to keep your eyes open and you have to do your research on that. What all institutes are there in India? For mathematics, if any of you is interested, there is CMO, there is ISI, Indian Statistical Institute. It has multiple branches. Similarly, there are IITs, so hai apne and IIST, like I told you, IIST is incredible, of course. And there are multiple channels to go into IIST. There is this KVPY, there is JEE mains and advanced ki through your test. So please look for your options. And before stepping into this, you should at least have a brief idea what you want to do. If you are more interested in one particular subject and not in the engineering part, then you don't have to run for the IIT wala race. Go very, like, you should know what you want at the end. So goal aapka, like, your purpose should be clear that this training that I'm doing, this practice that I'm doing is for this thing. And these are the requirements that you need for it. So based on that, you have to shape your training accordingly, right? And I'll tell you why I never went or even considered going to these Fijis and these big places. One big reason being that this coaching felt a lot like, you know, things are very flexible here. So if you need something, if there is a very individual need for you, you can propose it and you can ask for it and you will get it. I'm pretty sure Nitin sir has never said no to us and pretty sure he won't say it to anyone else because anyone who's willing to learn will get it there. So one thing is when you prepare, make sure your concepts are clear. Questions are secondary. Conceptually clear rakhna cheeze. If you have that in your head, no one can, because see, there will come a point where all of this will seem bahut hi bekar ki kyun kar rahe hain this, you know, the pressure is tremendous and it's sad ki apan log ko itne sare pressure ke through jana padta hai just to get to a place where we want to, but that is how it is. It's not going to change in the recent times, so might as well get accustomed to it. So get your concepts very clear as much as you can. And but हाँ ये भी है कि exams में सिर्फ concept is like 90%, but there's just 10% of tricks and tactics भी लगता है, which you will learn while you prepare. That okay, where you have to spend more time, where you have to, what is your strong area, you have to be very open minded for that. Where is your strong areas, where is your weak areas, कहाँ काम करना है, कहाँ के questions, what kind of questions should be avoided to save your time, what kinds of questions should be done in the first time or last में क्या करना है. So all of these strategies, and you will learn this. I mean, I'm sure all of you are smart enough to learn this while you go through the process. You don't have to worry about it right now. But just keep in mind, and from time to time, after 1 month, maybe at an interval of 1 month or 2 weeks, whatever suits you, think about what you're doing and where you want to be and what is needed more. Andha kuch mat karo. Don't just blindly follow it, but just see what you're doing. And you know, I'll tell you that that's again the best part about this place is like, you can go at your own pace. There is a very individual attention that you get. If you need it, I'm pretty sure sir will give you that and ma'am will give you that. There are all of those people. So itna zyada formal nahi hota yahan pe. That's the one good thing that I have really felt. That's why I probably 9th se leke 12th se leke drop year tak I stayed here. So, and it also is not like, you know, the all the other places have a very standard बैचेस में लोग ऐसे प्रोड्यूस कर रहे हैं, ऐसे यू नो एक बेल्ट जा रही है उसमें लोग जाए जा रहे इट्स लाइक बल्क प्रोडक्शन होता है. दैट इज नॉट हियर. आई मीन यू गेट वेरी कस्टमाइज थिंग्स. सो एंड एट द एंड ऑफ द डे एज लॉन्ग एज यू गेट योर कंसेप्ट, बिकॉज टीचर से यू विल गेट हाउ टू लर्न एंड बट दे कांट फीड यू विद वॉट आई मीन क्या कितना करना है. दे विल टेल यू कि तुम ये पढ़ोगे तो हो जाए, बिकॉज दोज पीपल आर एक्सपीरियंस. They will guide you towards it, but at the end of the day, it's going to be you who will have to put in the effort and who will have to understand everything. If you have doubts, I mean, you go to these people for guiding you, right? And that is the kind of guidance you're looking for. So for everyone, I mean, see, there is no strong or weak student. It's all about how you've developed your thinking or how you've shaped it. It's all about a matter of time and understanding. You get it there. कुछ लोगों को जल्दी पल्ले पड़ जाता है, लाइक आई हैड फ्रेंड्स. कुछ लोगों को थोड़ा धीरे धीरे समझ आता है, एंड बोथ ऑफ देम हैव देयर ओन स्ट्रेंथ्स. यू नो, जिसको धीरे भी समझ आता है, एक बार समझ आ गया, यू कांट टेक इट बैक फ्रॉम देम, दैट इज फॉर श्योर. सो इसलिए व्हाट आर योर रिक्वायरमेंट्स, शेप देम अप प्रॉपरली एंड ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज नीडेड. एंड आई थिंक यू आर एट अ प्रीटी नाइस प्लेस, एंड डोंट वेस्ट योर टाइम इन रैंडम थिंग्स, वरिंग अबाउट कि क्या कर रहे हैं, वो इंसान ज़्यादा आगे जा रहा है, वो उधर आगे जा रहा है. नो, जस्ट मेक श्योर कि अगर पिछले एग्जाम में 2 नंबर आए हैं ना, तो नेक्स्ट में 3 तो आने चाहिए. दिस यू शुड नॉट गो बैक. एज लॉन्ग एज यू गोइंग फॉरवर्ड, दैट्स गुड इनफ. ठीक है. एंड अदर थिंग्स, योर टीचर्स आर देयर टू गाइड यू इफ हाउ मच जम्प यू नीड और हाउ मच यू नीड टू वर्क हार्डर. सो दे विल एनी वे गाइड यू बिकॉज दे नो बेटर. But you have to make sure that from the last time you did, this time your effort should be greater. Not ki tumhara padosi ka kitna gaya hai, aage wale ka kitna gaya hai, piche wale ka kitna gaya hai. It does not matter. Because at the end, there's this one day that will decide everything for you. And thoda to luck usme bhi lagta hai, but it's fine. That, kya kar sakte hai? That it is what it is. So if you people have any questions, please feel free to ask. I would love to have some questions. Because I don't know what doubts you have in your head.
I had a question. First of all, what all you said, it is very relatable. I'm in 12th class, so I can see like 10th tak it was like ki boards hai, 10th ka board dena hai, that's all your aim. But 11th mein aake you are just blank. Matlab tumhe pata nahi tha, tumne PCM le li. But next question ye aa raha tha, tumhe karna kya aa gaya, you are blank that time.
Yeah.
So yeah, it took me some time to figure out कि मतलब अभी ऐसा है कि sort of अच्छा ये कर लेंगे ऐसा हो जाएगा. तो ऐसा हाल है. But it was very मतलब relatable आप जो कह रहे थे. What is the rank needed to in advance to go in IIST? Like I was considering IIST one of my dream colleges.
So rank.
एक सेकंड, आई हैव अ रिक्वेस्ट, दोज हु आस्क क्वेश्चन प्लीज स्विच ऑन योर कैमरास. ओके, या ठीक, श्रेया यू कैन
हां Okay. Hi, Adya. So, IST ka rank, I think last year it went till 10,000, like the last student that came. I think if you get it within 10,000, I think you will be in a safe spot to get into IST. See, the thing about IST is it's a new institute. That's why when people get an option between going to an IIT and going to an IST, they usually prefer IIT. But if you know what you want to do, because IST is very specific. I'm not kidding, hamare jo physics department ke professors hain, they are magic. They're literally made out of magic. They're incredible the way they teach. Because I did some project with, I mean, avionics department, but maine physics wale ke saath project kiya tha. Matlab maza hi dila dete hain guys. So IST ka best part yehi hai, pata hai, bahut kam bachche hain, we're very limited, but everyone gets a, like everyone can, you can literally just walk into a professor's office and be like, and these people are big shots. You just walk into their office and be like, sir, aaj achha nahi lag raha hai. And they'll tell you what a lot of things. So, ye rank, I think within 10,000, if you get it, you will be in a safe spot to get into IIST.
And for aerospace engineering, that stream also.
Aerospace, if you want to get into aerospace, then I think last week went like 8,000, 9,000. I think aerospace is the first preference for people because it's the, I don't know, maybe it sounds more space sciencey than avionics and engineering physics. But yeah, aerospace though, fortunately, it's there in multiple IITs also. So if you're considering aerospace, you can consider an IIT. NITs mein pata nahi hota ek bhi, but yeah, you can consider that.
Yeah, matlab maine iske colleges dekhe the fir aerospace ke, to usme IIT bhi ek to matlab the kuch, but
haan, sare 4-5 hain. I can tell you this college life is missing, but you know, it compensates with the kind of professors we have. So,
मैंने जब ये अपना मतलब बनाया कि ठीक है मुझे इस रोड में जाना है, इस पाथ पे जाना है मुझे, तो बहुत लोग का रिएक्शन था अरे बहुत टफ होता है, मतलब इजी नहीं होता है, ऐसा है क्या?
नहीं, इतना कुछ नहीं है. मतलब जेई देना सब, देखो एक बार जब तुम जेई एडवांस दे के वापस आ जाओगे ना, रैंक भूल जाओ. एक बार जब एडवांस देकर आप वापस आ जाओगे ना, जस्ट सेलिब्रेट लाइक हेल, फॉरगेट अबाउट हाउ योर एग्जाम, बिकॉज दिस एक्सट्रीम अमाउंट ऑफ प्रेशर दैट यू आर मेंट टू गो थ्रू इज समथिंग दैट्स, आई मीन आई डोंट नो, इट्स नॉट ह्यूमन इतना ज्यादा, बट अब क्या कर सकते, दिस इज समथिंग दैट यू हैव टू डील विद. सो इट्स नॉट सो टफ, यू गेट योर स्ट्रेटजीज राइट, यू नो, यू गेट टू नो व्हाट यू वांट टू डू, आई एम प्रीटी श्योर यू गेट देयर. इतना मुश्किल नहीं होता.
और आपका आ गए हो ये आप मतलब व्हाट इज योर वर्क, व्हाट विल बी योर वर्क इन इसरो?
ओके, सो आई विल बी जॉइनिंग एट साइंटिस्ट सी. तो साइंटिस्ट सी बेसिकली, हां, तो माय वर्क वुड डिपेंड ऑन द डिपार्टमेंट एंड द सेंटर आई जॉइन. सो इसरो के बहुत सारे सेंटर्स हैं, सो मोस्टली आई डोंट नो, बेस्ड ऑन द सीजीपीए यू गेट योर सेंटर्स. मे बी आई विल गो टू श्रीहरिकोटा, अगर तुम्हें पता है, पता है द सेंटर. तो जो भी एवियोनिक्स से काम दे दे, पेलोड बना लेंगे, स्पेसक्राफ्ट के अंदर का इंटीग्रेशन कर लेंगे. सो इट्स मल्टीपल टास्क. सी, स्पेस इंडस्ट्री एंड नॉर्मल इंडस्ट्री में, इफ यू लाइक, इफ यू गोइंग इनटू ईसी वाला पार्ट, तो व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन स्पेस एंड नॉर्मल? इतना कुछ नहीं, बस स्पेस इंडस्ट्री व्हेन यू कंसीडर इट, इट गेट्स वेरी सोफिस्टिकेटेड, बिकॉज एक नट भी ढीला हुआ, योर एंटायर मिशन इज गॉन. That is why when you work on this and you're sending in space, so the conditions are very different. Like there's a vacuum, the temperatures are extremely low, the pressure is extremely low. So wo sab ke chakkar mein, what you design is very specialized. That is the only difference between space industry and the normal industry that you make. Varna rocket bhi road pe chali jayega. Varna zyada kuch nahi hai. So yeah.
And what is that bond you were talking about, like?
Actually, it's no longer there. इसी साल हटा है. IIST has this bond because my education was entirely free. Zero पैसा लगा पूरा चार साल.
कुछ percentage से ऊपर आता है तो फिर वो.
हाँ, there is the seven. There was the 7.5 का criteria. So if you get above 7.5, CGPA system होता है when you go to college. it's not percentage nahi hota so cgpa system hota so if you get above 7.5 in every semester so at the end of the 4 years a cumulative cgpa hota wo hota hai that is like if it's above 7.5 then you get the job and so you have to sign this bond that if you are being offered a job by isro and if you are not taking that job so kuch logo ko further studies ke liye jana hota hai they are not taking that job you have to pay 10 lakhs to the institute department of space basically because they have funded you for the last 4 years so and you're leaving now so they have to pay matlab you have to pay for it so but now it has changed ab bond nahi hai so ab kya ho raha hai you'll have to pay the fees every semester irrespective of your cgpa but at the end of 4 years isro will come to your come to iist they will interview you and based on that they'll select you since isro does not go for interviews in it cannot go for interviews in any other institute because iits may be in ja sakte because there is this icrb exam hota hai so for anyone who's outside iist who wants to get into isro they have to give this icrb exam after bachelors and fir isro mein aate hain but iist has this plus point because bana uc ke liye to that's the thing okay anything else
not now I'll agar kuch aur question
anyone else wants to ask anything
but I wanted to ask Anurag
Anurag bolo then Anna will uske baad batana
yes sir I wanted to know that what all degrees are required like
degrees
like, minimum degrees or you will need this at least
for what
for going to isro
तो यू हैव टू हैव अ बैचलर्स डिग्री
ओके ओके थैंक यू
अनबिल
आई हैड अ क्वेश्चन आई एम रीमा I had a question. Is there an entrance exam for after advance for IIST?
No. You get directly from the IIST ka this advance ka rank. So, but there is a separate form. Yeah, don't miss out on that. After mains, I think it just check the dates. I don't know for sure, but I think after mains it's released or maybe after advance. So you have to fill that form. So keep everyone make a list. I think sir will also provide you with this, but make a list of all the exams you have to give. Please don't miss out on any opportunity that is possible. So make a list of all the exams you want to get and their timelines when and when they come.
Also, if you could tell something about ICVR exam.
ICRB actually gate ki tarah hi hota hai. Usme there's not anything else. So if you've done BTEC from any other college, you can sit in that exam. I don't know the course structure or the syllabus kya hota hai uska, but just Google it once you'll get it. I mean, and you don't need to worry about it right now. अभी छोड़ो ये सब हो ये दैट विल बी आफ्टर 12th एंड आफ्टर योर बीटेक सो दैट्स अ लॉन्ग टाइम लेट इट बी फॉर नाउ या
ओके ओके सो आई वांटेड टू आस्क दैट यू राइट नाउ ओनली मेंशनड अर्लियर दैट देयर आर अनफॉर्चूनेट इंसिडेंट्स व्हिच आर हैपनिंग व्हिच हैपेंड लाइक अपोलो 13 और कोलंबिया सो आफ्टर ऑल दोस इंसिडेंट्स डू यू थिंक दैट सिटीजनशिप प्रोग्राम्स स्टिल हैव विल बी एबल टू मेक एन इंपैक्ट फॉर एग्जांपल इन एस्ट्रोनॉमी citizenship programs. For example, in astronomy, there was a space object named Hannes Burwitt, which was discovered by citizens. So, in ISRO, is there any chance for any citizen engineer who put forward his plans, who is not in ISRO but he can give his plans in that way?
I don't know that itna zyada depth because I have not stepped inside ISRO right now yet. But kuch na kuch to I'm pretty sure there must be some program because every industry has this some program to you know link between the citizens and the industry so I think there should be something once I get into it I'll let you know if I get something out of it
thank you
I have a question
yeah
so my question is what was your basic strategy when you were researching for your college Like, what aspects did you take into consideration
when I was searching for my college?
Yeah.
हाँ, Okay, so when you're looking for a college, one thing is what degree do you want? If you want a BTech or if you want a BSc or you want a BA, not BA to apan log ki company, but yeah, whatever kind of degree that you want, first look for that. Okay, once you've decided on the degree, or in fact not even the degree, maybe what you can do is search for engineering institute in India, best engineering institutes. Go to their pages, see their course structure. Please make sure to see the course structure because usse bahut sari cheeze pata chal jati hai. So you know, like go into IIT Delhi ka see and see how the physics department is, how the electrical department is based on your preferences. So this is kuch, you know that mechanical mein to nahi jana, for example, like I was of that type ki mechanical mein to nahi jana. So I looked for places which were offering, so I went to like IIT Delhi ka page and saw that electrical department mein kya kya hai, the kind of course structure they offer for the BTech program. So her programs on every website of the university, you will get a very proper course structure. Just skim through it, just get an idea of what all they'll be teaching and how it's going to be. Okay? Yeah.
Thanks.
Okay. Anyone else wants to ask anything?
Can you please shed some light on five-year dual degree program?
Oh, that's actually a very good program. Engineering physics ka hai. So if you people are interested in physics as a core, and so 5-year dual degree mein kya hota hai? 3 years ka engineering hota hai. And engineering physics is actually a very special branch because it teaches you engineering wala side and the core physics as well. Had I properly researched, I would have probably preferred engineering physics over avionics after a time. But anyway, so engineering physics mein you get 3 years ka BTech degree, and after 3 years you're given a choice between the master programs which you want to choose. So next 2 saal ke liye chalenge. So there are 4, I think. Yeah, solid state physics hai. Solid state physics is basically, to boil it down, it's basically your semiconductor physics ho gaya, and atoms or molecules, molecular level pe kya kya hota hai, all of those things. Next is your optical engineering, optical physics wala part hai. So they deal with light, all kinds of light. So light can do magic. Once you go into that, you'll know. Third, astronomy and astrophysics. These people work with the all the stars and the galaxies and the kind of instruments that are needed to study these structures. And fourth is earth and space sciences. Earth and space sciences is studying the atmosphere, the climate, the climatologists and all. जो होते हैं meteorologists जो होते हैं, basically weather predictions कैसे होती हैं. So those kind of things are the fourth branch. So there are 4 options once you to go into that. But engineering physics as a whole is actually a really good subject if you are into physics a bit. So it's actually very good.
What are the criteria for this getting to 5-year dual degree program?
There is a separate criteria. It's based on the way you rank structure. So basically, if there are 1,000 people applying, so you have to fill a form of first preference, second preference, third preference. So like if your first preference is engineering physics, and based on your rank, jab aapka number aayega, if the seats are available, they'll give it to you. So I guess if for the same engineering physics also, if you have within 10,000 ka rank, you will get in. Just look at last year's stats as well. Like not last year's, when you are going to join, usse pehle ka stats dekh lena, you'll get a brief idea. Anything else?
Yeah, Rachna ma'am, aap kuch kehna cha rahe the?
No, I'm very much happy with the way Shreya is taking this up, and I think I'm able to understand. For me, it's too new, and since my child has just gone to the 11th, and all of this would really help me to decide and talk to him about this before we really go further down the line.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks, Shreya, for your time. It really helped me a lot.
I get it.
All day long is a very, very tough scenario for a parent.
Yeah, yeah, I understand.
But when it comes from a person who has lived those areas of work and has done every bit every day, has gone into it, it's a very clear picture. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, yeah, no problem. because I get it, I was on the same stage, completely clueless, trying to figure out what to do. So, okay. And my parents were pretty chill with, do what you want to do in life. And I was like, yeah, maybe something. So yeah, I get it. If people have any other problem.
I had one other doubt, like if you are graduating from IIST, then do you think of PhD or Masters? And if you think
very then... much, very much. Actually, see, once you study in IIST, you know, the actually ye jo bond hai ISRO ka, it comes to me more as a problem than you know, a good thing, because ab after being in a research institute for these 4 years,
no more after.
Exactly, and I want to study further, but abhi 10 lakh bharenge rukke thoda, so I want to go to, I'll go in ISRO and see what all, because ISRO mein there are a lot of opportunities of research as well, but hai to sarkari system, and naukri karna is something I wanted to stall it further for some years, but I'll see, I'll decide as and when, but definitely I'll go for higher studies.
Like, which colleges do you have in mind for PhD or master?
Honestly, once I've studied at IIST, and I know that India mein the best that they offer for BTech is IISTs, IITs and all these. So, I want to go out now, like out of India, and do my learn research and see how it is there. And then maybe come back after some years and work there. So,
like outside, which colleges you have? Like you think like these colleges are like good and I can go there?
Huh, so if you are looking in US, there are a lot of, you know, universities like MIT, ho gaya, Harvard, ho gaya, but there are a lot of colleges like Ivy League colleges, hai, like Columbia Institute, University. Hai. And if you look, when you look in the research all aside, although I don't think it's that in detail where you people need it, but I'll just briefly tell you. When you look into the research side, you see the outside world as USA and Europe. These are the two places where people generally go. You can also go to Australia, but that is very specific to what you need. But engineering sites or science sites, these two are prominent places. So Europe, mein, you can go to France if you want to work in atomic and molecular physics. You can go to Germany, I mean, at least if you're interested in automobile. I'm just broadly saying it, aisa kuch itna specific hai nahi. But you can just look into the institute. There are a lot of institutes are doing incredible research. And even if there are very good institutes which we don't know about. Jaise IISc mein jaisa research ho raha hai, hamare IISc mein kuch jagah pe ho raha hai. And then there is this place, Raman Research Institute hai. Mathematics, ISI, these are incredible places. So if you want to do research, you can always go into these places.
And many people think of like that they do graduation from here, then go for postgrad in some other country, and for exposure and all, more knowledge and all that stuff.
Yeah.
And then there is a new, like in research work, they you know, have a startup, or people think of like that also. So have you thought about like that, or like making a startup?
Actually I have, because how I see it, like my interests are actually pata jab ek bar upar uth jate hai na, graduation ho jata hai na, tab samajh aata hai that science is not segregated into physics, chemistry, maths, biology. It's literally all one. You cannot segregate them. It's just that you have to choose ki kya club karna hai kaise. So even I am planning something, well, not planning, but thinking of going into a different direction as after this. But we'll see. Abhi to time hai. Thoda wo karenge. Abhi apni thesis likhni hai. Wo khatam kar le, and then we'll have that. Actually, there is this one thing that we started last year when the lockdown was going on. So we had a lot of free time. Hamari college wale, me and a bunch of my friends. So what we started was we started recording conversations that we had with our professors. So we started a podcast series based on that. Out of nowhere, so if you people want to listen to something very particular to a field, for example, we had this first episode with astrophysicist from our institute itself. So you know, you will get a very brief idea. Upar upar se pata chal jayega ka kya hai. Just a second, I can share the link with you as well. If you people want, just skim through it. You, I mean, this will give you an idea of what kind of research exists in the world. A very brief thing, but yeah, थोड़ा आइडिया मिल जाएगा. सो जस्ट स्किम थ्रू इट, लिसन टू सम ऑफ देम, जो भी टॉपिक तुम्हें इंटरेस्ट में आए. दिस इज जस्ट आवर प्रोफेसर्स टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ दे डिड इन लाइफ एंड व्हाट आर दे वर्किंग ऑन राइट नाउ. एंड आई विल गिव यू अ पर्सनल रिकमेंडेशन, लिसन टू दिस सीजन 2 का फर्स्ट एपिसोड है बाय उमेश आर कड़ाने ऑन एटॉमिक एंड मॉलिकुलर फिजिक्स. He is this amazing professor. Just listen to that. And it's like this one and I think this astrophysics wala also you should listen. These two I would say, this is my personal recommendation. Rest based on your interest. We also have one by a scientist of ISRO who was a professor at our institute. So you just see what your interests are. Because explore, you people need to know what your options are. You're not limited just by these 4 or 5 options. There are incredible amount of options, and don't limit yourself on what you can do. Because trust me, if you people decide to do something, you can, and you get it in the right directions for which you have your teachers, you are going to literally reach the stars. It's amazing to the amount of, you know, the caliber that we as students have. We just undermine ourselves and, you know, doubt ourselves so much. कि अरे पिछले पेपर में 10 नंबर कम आ गए अब तो जिंदगी ही खत्म हो गई. दैट इज नॉट हाउ इट इज. इट्स दीज आर जस्ट नंबर्स एंड आई अंडरस्टैंड दिस कैन बी वेरी सैडनिंग एट टाइम एंड बहुत मोरल डाउन कर देते हैं. एंड जेईई इज समथिंग दैट रिक्वायर्स यू टू हैव कॉन्स्टेंट एफर्ट्स पुट इन रेगुलरली. सो यू हैव टू कीप एट इट एंड जस्ट नो दैट इवन इफ यू फीलिंग टेरेबल एट टाइम्स, जस्ट नो दैट यू हैव टू गो थ्रू इट टू फिनिश इट. बट डोंट फिनिश योरसेल्फ इन दिस होल जर्नी. मेक श्योर टू take your hobbies seriously. Chota chota hi rakho, just to, because have a free mind. If you don't have an open and free mind, it's going to be very hard to get through it. So have something chota, anything that you like. Listen to music, explore it, watch movies sometimes, but do that sometimes, because along with studying science and all this JEE ka preparation, you also need to free your mind. So don't pressurize yourself too much. And if there is any external pressure, Nitin sir se aap wo bhi discuss kar sakte ho. That's actually a kind of free space that he provides. So if you want, you can talk to him as well about these things, because he has gone through the same thing and I have also gone through the same thing. And honestly, I'll tell you, after giving JEE, my parents were like, "Gate ka exam kyun nahi de rahe the, beta?" I did not need gate ka exam, but they just wanted me to give an attempt and see what score I stand in, or you know how it is. And like after giving JEE, no, that was like the last competitive exam I'll ever give in my life. I am done with the competitive exam, because that is how I want my life. Because I want to go into research as professor. I don't want to go into industry itna zyada. But it's of course all your preferences and all your personal choices. So just think about things. Thoda zyada socho. Socho zyada. Don't just, you know, ridiculously do efforts and efforts. Think what you're doing and why you're doing it. The purpose behind doing something is very important, and that is the only reason that will get you to the end point of the race. Otherwise, purpose lost hua to matlab hi nahi bachega. I can tell you this. So yeah.
What was the name of yours, Umesh? Something like
Umesh R. Kadhane. Season 2 ka I think first episode hai. Something aise. You can find it in the link. On atomic and molecular physics. It should be something like this. Yeah, just see, you'll get it, I guess. Okay. If you don't, then you can. If you have any other doubts, I mean, you people can actually send me a mail if you want, because I understand these are difficult times and it's not easy to get through them. Given the abhi ka jo situation chal raha hai, to aur bhi zyada terrible hai. School ki shakal bhi dekhne ko nahi milti. थोड़ा बहुत टाइम पास हो जाता था वो भी बंद हो गया है. सो या स्पेंड सम टाइम मे बी आसमान दिखते हुए या पौधों के साथ, कुछ ह्यूमेन होगा आसपास. या सर, इफ देयर इज एनीथिंग एल्स प्लीज लेट मी नो.
कैन यू शेयर ईमेल आईडी स्टोर लाइक.
हां, श्योर.